I'm going to kind of let the cat out of the bag here, John. You did a very famous private label that the name is still out there today, but the formula that started the label is no longer supplied to them?
No, it has not been available under that trademark since 1984.
I can be the rat. I'm going to let the cat out of the bag. And what's that label?
That was Slick 50.
No, you didn't start Slick 50. I've heard that Ethel started it, Ethel Corporation. I've heard that Joe Schmuckatelli started
it. Started.
All these different people. So Mr. John Bishop started Slick 50.
1978. Okay. And what brought it about was, like I mentioned earlier, we were doing retail. And we were doing okay, except we were never going to get, around the world, so to speak. And direct-to-consumer marketing, or multi-level marketing, as they call it, is a good way to market products person-to-person. And our product really fits in well that way, because you can tell the customer what it does, answer their questions, show them the test data and so forth, where actually on a retail shelf, they don't have, the clerks don't have time to do that. You're just one of a few up there. So 1978, we put it out in a direct marketing concept under the Slick 50 label. And within 18 months, we were in 32 countries.
And that's how some of these foreign tests came along?
Yes, exactly. That's where some of the foreign tests came about.
So you obviously quit supplying your partners back then. You had some other guys involved in the company.
Well, unfortunately, I was forced to take some legal action in 83. I took a judgment in 84, and I quit supplying the product in 84. The unfortunate thing is I did not trademark the trade name under my manufacturing company.
And that name is still out there today?
It's still out there today.
And it has
changed hands a few times.
Right.
But
a couple of big oil companies owned it for a little while?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Quaker State bought it in 94, I believe. And then Pennzoil bought Quaker State. Now Shell bought Pennzoil. So Shell actually owns that trademark.
But, I have two documents that said that, even Pennzoil and their Jiffy Lube said, you're not supposed to sell Slick 50. And that was based not on your formula, but on the formula that...
That was prior to them owning it.
Okay.
All right? That was prior to them owning it. Yeah, because that was the product that came along after I stopped supplying them. It caused some problems
What was it, in 89? You sued them again and made them take all the claims off?
89, I sued them again and got a cease and desist because they was using my documentation testimonials to sell the product, then marketing under the Slick 50 label, yes.
So straight from the horse's mouth, you started Slick 50. You don't supply them today.
No.
And the formula that you did supply them is the one that actually foundationally formed and, I guess, kicked Slick 50 off back then?
Oh, it was. That was it. That was a foundation. Yeah, sure.
Well, I guess everybody knows now, don't they?
Well, that was a marketing company, and nobody really knew who I was or anything. There was really no need for them to know at the time. It was just that was a marketing concept, and that was the product that was marketed and did very well and went all over the world. And then, unfortunately, things happened that should have happened, and I had to take some action, and then, unfortunately, the product was no longer available to the people under that label.
So consumers today probably still think they're getting the good stuff.
Some do, until they use it.
I've heard that I don't know how many times. It changes. It's different. It's not the same.
Right.